Hello, I'm Justin from Steam for Vietnam. I am collaborating with the Scratch team to explore creating a culturally and geographically relevant asset pack in the Scratch editor that can be shared with other Scratchers around the globe.
Hi, I'm Marin, aka Algorithmer from the Scratch team.
To start creating an original sprite or asset pack, you want to sign into your account and start a new project. Click Create in the header. Note, you can create assets using the offline editor or without being logged in to the online editor, but you'll need to save your project to your computer in order to save your work or share later. You could upload an image or sound or edit sprites that are already in the Scratch library to create an asset. But for this example, Justin is going to show us how to create an original sprite by drawing a costume. Hover over the sprite menu in the lower right corner of the sprite area and choose Paint, which brings you to a blank costume window under the Costumes tab. There are two modes for drawing in Scratch. Bitmap mode allows you to edit photos and paint with pixels. Vector mode allows you to create and edit shapes. If you're creating your own sprites, it's important you stay in the default vector mode to create your artwork. Vector mode allows users to adjust colors, change the shape of an object in the costume, add and remove elements, etc. If users remix your assets, this flexibility is important. Now back to Justin.
Let's get into drawing the bow fun. First, I'll choose the circle here. For the bow, I would like to use the fill color that's slightly orange. And then I'll choose an outline of the rim of the bow is slightly brown. Awesome. Now I will start drawing. Hit Alt or Option to drag from the middle. And then use this tool, select tool, to move around. Now the rim seems a bit thin. I will increase it probably to 10. Next step, I'm going to make the bottom of the bow. I will use this and hit copy and paste. Then I'll move it to the back. I'll drag it down a little bit here. And then I'll change the fill color to more slightly orange. And I will choose the outline color same using the color picker tool. Next, I'll use this reshape tool. I click on the top point and then I hit delete. Next, let's draw some pho noodles in there. To draw the pho noodles, I'm going to use a line. And then the pho noodle is usually white. So I'll drag it to here. The thickness is 10 for now. The noodles is usually wavy, right? So how can we do that? I'll use the reshape tool. Click on here, choosing this point, and then hit curve. Then I can move this handle to adjust the curve like I want. If you by chance hit another point and then it creates, you can always hit back or delete that point. Now let's make some wavy noodles in a bow. Use the select tool, copy and paste. Use the reshape tool. A bow of noodles. Next, let's add some beef in here. So in pho, I like to have a brisket. So we're gonna draw a shape that look like a rounded rectangular. Okay, so how should we do that? First, I'll choose the circle tool, but it's usually cooked to medium rare or medium. So I'll use this color. I would choose the reshape tool, make the top handles longer to make it look more like a rounded rectangle. Now this piece look more 3D a little bit by copy and paste and offset it diagonal and bring to the back. I'll change the color to slightly darker. Use the select tool, choose the two shapes, group it, bring it to our bow fur here. Next, we're gonna put some basil leaves in here. I'll make one of it slightly darker color so it can separate out. Finally, we will draw a slide of lime in here. Okay, here's a tip. If you want to do a perfect circle, you can hit shift on your keyboard while you drag it. I would use a reshape tool, delete this bottom point. The slide of lime will be a half circle. I will make a slightly smaller white half circle in here. I will draw two white lines to make it look like a slide of lime. But actually it does have some scallions in there, but I don't like it on my foot. So voila, we have a bow of fur here.
While it isn't required, consider creating at least two costumes for your sprite. to show animation or variation. You can duplicate a costume to quickly create another version by simply right-clicking on the costume you want to copy and then choose Duplicate from the menu. You could create alternative looks by adding or removing elements or changing colors. Or you can think of how your sprite might be animated, with each costume serving as a frame of the animation.
So now, when you click alternatively between two costumes, moving just like the elements was floating in a bowl of soup, be sure to also name the sprite. You can change the name in the sprite area by entering new text in the field next to sprite. Even though it is optional, considering adding at least one related sound for each sprite you create, select the sound tab. Hover the sounds menu at the bottom of the tab and choose to upload a sound or record your own. Here, I'm going to make a sound of my compliments when I am eating pho in Vietnamese. Yeah, already. The thing that I just say means, oh, it's so delicious. Once your sound is recorded, you can use the sound editor to make edits, like turning the length or adjusting the volume. I took a picture of the local pho restaurant in Vietnam. You can upload an image or picture as a sprite.
If you want to create a backdrop asset, you could add one using the Backdrops menu. However, when creating an asset pack to share, we recommend creating your backdrop as a sprite instead. Backdrops created as sprites can be more easily exported, especially when they contain sounds or multiple versions.
I can click this Convert to Vector button to change it to vector format, which allows me to move it around as an object if I want to resize or reposition it. When your asset pack project is ready, name your project and share it to the online community by clicking the share button. Now, your asset can be remixed and used by others. To help others find your asset pack, you can look for studios that match the theme of your asset pack or for studios that are specifically collecting assets back.
Now that we've explored creating an asset, in our next video, we'll talk about using another user's asset from their asset pack in your projects.